Hallelujah. Greetings to all the brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. 各位弟兄姐妹，问大家的安。
So happy to see everyone in the last Sabbath of 2021.
在2021年的最后一个安息日，非常感谢主，我们可以大家在这里相见。
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ continue to be with us for the coming new year.
愿主的平安与恩典在未来一年继续与大家同在。
This afternoon, my topic for mutual encouragement is follow him fully.
今天下午的题目是专一跟随他。
Let's turn to the book of Numbers, chapter 14.
我们一起来翻到民数记十四章。
Numbers, chapter 14, verse 23, 24.
民数记十四章的二十四节。
Numbers, chapter 14, verse 24.
民数记十四章二十四节。唯独我的仆人加勒，因他另有一个心志，专一跟从我，我就把他领进他所去过的那地，他的后裔也必得那地为业。
This is what God said about Caleb.
这是神对加勒说的话。
Caleb is a very special worker of God.
加勒是一个非常特别的工人。
Among millions of Israelites, he was only the few among Joshua, only two of them.Who can enter the land of Canaan?
在几百万的以色列人当中，只有约书亚与加勒能够进去迦南地。
The other members, the other people, they were numbered. They couldn't enter the land of Canaan.
除了他们两个之外，其他人都没有办法进去。
Because the majority of other people, they complain against God, they disbelieve God.
因为大多数人都不相信神，而且发怨言。
However, Joshua and Caleb, especially Caleb, here mentioned.
在加勒这个人的身上
，God like him very much.
神非常的喜欢他
，because God said he is the one who follow me fully.
因为神说他是一个专一跟从我的人。
Fully means 100%. It's not discounted.
专一就是没有任何的打折，是全心全意的。
Nowadays we do many things, but usually we are very distracted.
今天我们可以做很多事情，可是常常我们都是分心的在做。
We know that when we do something with distraction, usually we'll fail.Very dangerous.
我们知道我们做一件事情如果不专心的时候有时候会带来危险。
Look at nowadays how people drive.
现在看很多人在开车的时候。
Sometimes I pass through the highway, I'm looking at the people on the side if I'm not driving.
有时候当我坐在车上没有在开车的时候我会看一看身边的车子。
In the highway, people are driving 110 kilometers per hour, but some people are still texting.
有时候看到人在高速开车他们虽然开得非常的快可是还同时在打手机。
On Highway 1, some people are driving like this.
有的人开车甚至是一下看路，一下看手机。
These people are afraid so much. I want to be far away from them. I don't want them to crash into my car.
看到这种人的车，我通常都会离他们远一点。
However, nowadays, most people are distracted.
那现在大家常常都是这样在做事的。
On the red light, when the green turned red, the people in the front of you are not moving. Why? Texting, using the cell phone.
当你看到前面的红灯已经变成绿灯了，可是你前面的车没有在动，是不是因为他低头在看什么呢
？Look at young people when they do the homework.
我们看现在的年轻人，他们在做功课的时候
，What did they do?
他们怎么做功课呢
？Open the YouTube, and then the cell phone, checking social media, and then the ears listening to the music.
他眼睛看着电脑，同时又开着手机，然后耳中还听着音乐。
They call it multitasking.
他说这个是可以同时能够做很多事。
However, psychologists actually have told us if you are so-called multitasking, actually you cannot multitask. You're just switching your attention here and there, here and there. You slow down the things that you've been doing.
不过心理学家分析给我们听，他们并不是同时在做好多事，他们只是把自己的专心一下移到这个地方，一下移到那个地方。
And something take 5 minutes. If you are distracted, you can even take 1 hour. You have not even do it well.
有时候五分钟可以做好的事情，因为分心着在做，一个小时也做不好。
So nowadays some computer or cell phone they have the do not disturb mode, right? So if you want to get something done, you want to have full attention, then you have to switch to the do not disturb mode.
所以现在手机有一个功能，就是说不打搅的功能。所以如果你想要专心做一件事，或许你要把你的手机转到这样的功能去。
And if you're really focused, then you can get something done very importantly.
这样你就可以全心把一件事情做好再说。
Same when we follow God in this heavenly journey.
现在我们一样在走天路的。
We have to switch on the do not disturb mode.
我们也要开动这个功能，就是不要打搅的功能。
If you are disturbed, if you are distracted,
如果你常常被其他的事情打扰而分心的话，
usually even though you follow God in the middle of the way or somewhere, you just be distracted and leave and forget.
就算你现在在跟从主，可是半路出现什么事情，就很容易把我们的专心拿走。
The people of Israelites, they followed God so happily when they left Egypt.
所以当以色列百姓他们离开埃及的时候是非常的开心的。
But they were distracted along the way.
可是在半路上有人就被分心了。
But this Caleb, he was not distracted.
可是这个加勒不一样。
He followed God fully.
他专一的跟从神。
So today we're going to learn from him.
所以今天我们要从他来学习。
How Caleb managed to follow God from the first day he left Egypt until he reached Canaan.
我们来学习他如何从第一天跟从主一直到最后一天。
We have to learn from him.
我们要向他学习。
Because from the day we are baptized, just like we left Egypt, crossing the Red Sea.
所以我们今天走天国路上，就像从第一天我们受洗那天开始，然后经过红海。
Just like crossing the Red Sea, representing baptism.
经过红海其实就是预表着洗礼。
But you have not entered heaven yet.
可是你还没有进到天国。
You have to reach the heavenly shore. You have to reach the promised land.
你要进到迦南地
Until the day you die, see whether you can go to heaven.
就是在我们过世的那一天，看看我们能不能到达天国的门。
If you can follow God fully,
如果我们可以专一跟从神，
then you can make it.
这样我们就可以做到。
Now, Caleb overcome at least three distractions so that he can make it to the end.
加勒他至少通过三个考验，才能够走到迦南地的门口。
Let's see what are they.
我们来看看这是什么。
The first one.
第一个
He overcome the test of distraction about other people's comment, other people's thinking.
第一个是他胜过人对他的看法这个考验。
Let's turn to Numbers chapter 13.
我们来看民数记第十三章。
Numbers chapter 13.
民数记十三章。
From this chapter, we know that Caleb was one of the 12 spies that were sent to look at the land of Canaan.
这里我们知道加勒是他们派出去窥探迦南地的十二个支派之一。
Let's read chapter 13, verse 6.
第十三章第六节。
Let's please read.
第六节属犹大支派的有耶弗尼的儿子加勒。
Now, Caleb represents the tribe of Judah.
加勒代表犹大支派。
At that time, each tribe shall send one of their leaders.
这里是每一个支派就要派出他们的领导者。
So that they are the spies that go to the spy the land of Canaan.
所以这十二个族长他们就被派去窥探迦南地。
And they spend 40 days.
他们花了40天来窥探。
And they come back.
然后就回来。
When they come back, oh, they bring a lot of huge grapes, huge fruits, and very beautiful produce about the land of Canaan.
当他们回来的时候手上带着非常好的耐地的出产。包括很大颗的葡萄。
So they bring the news, say they prove that the land that God has promised actually was exceedingly good.
他们发现那个地方真的是非常的美好，就像神所说的一样。
However, the rest of the spies, the 11 spies, they bring bad news.
可是其他的探子他们发出不好的消息。
Let's read verse 27, chapter 13, verse 27 to 28.
我们来看看民数记十三章的二十七节。二十七节又告诉摩西说：“我们到了你所打发我们去的那地，果然是流奶与蜜之地，这就是那地的果子。”二十八节，然而住那地的民强壮，诚意也坚固宽大，并且我们在那里看见亚纳族的人。
Look at how the majority of the people, the spies, what they said about the land.
我们在这里看见了其他的探子他们说的话。
They say, the land is good, no problem.
他们说那地的确非常的好。
But, verse 28, but, right? Sometimes you don't want to hear the word but.
28节提到然而。
If your boss say that, you perform quite well, but, then you should be worried.
如果你的老板说你做得不错,不过。
Or your teacher say, okay, you are fine, but. But means something is not going good.
如果你的老师说你做得很好,不过。那就代表有一些事情是他要告诉你的。
If a customer say, I want to buy, but that means he's not going to buy.
如果你的客户说，我想要买这个东西，可是，那你就知道他没有要买。
So the 11 spies say, yeah, the land God is good, but what?
那些探子他们说，住在那个地方的确是非常好，可是。
But the people are too strong. People are strong, taller.
可是那地的民非常的强壮，也比我们高大。
You know, the chosen people, compared to the local Canaanite, it's different.
哦，我们知道，迦南地的人，他们跟以色列人是不一样的。
They are stronger built.
他们长得非常的高大。
Now we are all Asian here, right? Our height is average, but compared to the Caucasian, compared to the Northern European, oh, we are so short.
哦，我们知道，我们亚洲人对比一般的北美的人，甚至是北欧的人，我们是不太是比较矮小的。
So this Israelites, they look at the land, they look at the people. Wow, they are like so big.
所以他们看到那地方的人那么强壮。
And they live in big city.
而且他们住在很大的城。
So they say, it's very difficult.
他们就说这个太困难了。
But Caleb was not distracted.
不过迦勒不一样。
Let's read verse 30.
我们看第三十节。
Verse 30.
三十节，迦勒在摩西面前安抚百姓说：“我们立刻上去得那地吧，我们足能得胜。”
So look at Caleb. He actually has the heart, strong heart to rely on God and even try to comfort other people.
我们看到迦勒在这里有一个坚强的心，他甚至还在摩西面前安抚百姓。
However, other people don't listen.
不过其他人不听。
Verse 31.
三十一节，但那些和他同去的人说，我们不能上去攻击那民，因为他们比我们强壮。
32.
探子中有人论到所窥探之地，向以色列人报恶信说，我们所窥探经过之地是吞吃居民之地，我们在那里所看见的人民都身量高大。33. 我们在那里看见亚纳族人，就是伟人，他们是伟人的后裔，据我们看自己就如蚱蜢一样，据他们看我们也是如此。
Now look at the majority. What are the common thinking of everyone among the spies?
我们在这里可以看到多数人的想法。
Some said, no, we cannot do it.
有些人说，哦，我们没办法进去的。
Because they are too strong for us, they are stronger than us.
因为他们比我们强壮。
Some even are exaggerating.
有一些把它更戏剧化了。
Oh, they are just like giants, they devour us like grasshopper.
他们就像巨人一样，他们会把我们吃掉的。
Wow, look at the majority of opinion.
我们看看多数人的意见是如何呢？
Sometimes we think democracy is good.
我们有时候看到民主是好。
Oh, let's vote. See what do we do?
我们来投票吧，看看多数人怎么决定。
But actually, the Bible never really promote democracy to make the right decision spiritually.
不过在圣经里面并不鼓励我们现在在做属灵的决定的时候是用投票来决定。
Because if you have a vote here, like 12 people have a vote, I think the only votes that say go, let's go to get the land, they only got one vote.
好，我们看看这个地方的探子。他们所讲的其实多数票就是决定我们不要进去了。
Only the one who want to go only one vote. The other 11 say no.
可能就是只有迦勒会说好。
Now, sometimes when we go out with friends or go out with other people or do something.
有时候我们跟我们的朋友出去。
If your opinion is the only opinion that's different than other people, what will you do?
如果你发现你的意见是跟其他人不一样的，这时候你会怎么做呢？
I think sometimes...We tend to be, okay, we change myself, okay, let's do what most other people think, what is right.
有时候我们会改变自己的表达，就说，大家都说的不错，我们就这样做吧。
You know, there's a lot of social experiments talking about the power of peer pressure.
其实有很多报告指出对于同侪之间的压力。
That usually when we go into a setting, when you see the majority of the people doing something, even though you don't think it's right, but usually you just go with the flow.
那这些实验里面说到，就是你在一个环境里面，如果你发现你跟自己做、跟其他人做的事情不太一样，我们是会想要改变自己的。
One of the very social experiments is in a setting like in a waiting area of a doctor's office.
曾经我看过一个实验，他们是在一个医生的诊所所做的实验。
So they place a lot of actors who are already know what to do and they are.Being a part of the experiment to test other people.
在这个实验里，他们一开始就找了几个演员坐在那个等候区，然后这些演员都知道自己要做什么。
And then they will just stand up and sit in a regular time interval.
他们在特定的时间里面，他们会站起来，然后再坐下。
For no reason, but they just do it together. Stand up and sit down. Stand up and sit down.
在他们这几个人里面都非常的有默契，他们知道一个时间到了，他们就要站起来，然后坐下。
Now, when somebody didn't know about this experiment, those are the targets, right? They go in to see the doctor and in the waiting room.
那当其他不知情的人，他们走进来也要等着看医生的时候，他们就是要被实验的人。
Of course, usually in a normal setting, you just sit there to wait until you go into the doctor's office.
那当然你要去看医生的时候你就是走进去坐下来等候那个小姐叫你。
But when other actors, right, who are acting as other patients, stand up and sit, stand up and sit.
那当那些演员他们已经坐在那里了，然后他们在特定时间他们就站起来，然后才坐下。
And when those who didn't know what's going on and they see other people, oh, stand up and sit, and then you guess what happened?
所以当那些来看医生，真正来看医生的人，他们就看见这些演员站起来坐下，站起来坐下。你猜猜他们怎么做？
Most of them, they will just follow, even though they don't know why they follow.
所以来看医生的人，他们就跟着站起来，还有坐下，虽然他们不知道为什么要这样做。
Because they see everyone is standing, so maybe I better stand.
所以当他们看到其他人站起来的时候，他就想说，那我最好是也跟着站起来吧。
And when other people just sit down, I better sit.
那别人站起来又坐下，那我就跟着站起来又坐下。
And follow the rhythm.
然后就跟着这个节奏来走。
And even all the other actors, they went into the room and disappeared. He continued to do this regular interval.
当这些演员一个一个被叫进去，好像看医生之后，这些来看医生的人还是继续做着一样的动作。
Even leading other people to do the same thing.
甚至他们还带领着后来来看医生的人做同样的动作。
Very interesting.
这是非常有趣的实验。
You think it's very silly, right? Why you follow other people?
有时候我们会想说，怎么会这么傻呢？就这样跟着吗
？But this is called peer pressure.
可是这就是同侪之间的压力。
When a lot of people, majority of the people around you.Say the same thing, do the same thing, or think a certain way, you tend to follow them.
当你身边的人都在说着一样的话，思考着一样的想法，你就会自然而然就跟上了。
Even though originally you didn't plan to do it.
可能你自己本来是不愿意这样做的。
But when one or two or three start other people saying this, oh, don't go there, it's too difficult. And they'll say, yeah, yeah, it's too difficult.
不过当你身边的人开始说，哦，我们不要进去吧，那里太可怕了。那一个两个三个我们就会跟着。
But Caleb, he is not the same kind of the person.
不过加勒完全不同。
Yeah, a lot of distraction. The majority is the distraction. Other people is his distraction.
是的，大家都这么说，可是他不愿意跟着。
Most people say it's too difficult, it's impossible, you cannot do it.
所有的人都几乎都这样说，这是太恐怖的任务，我们不可能做的。
Or we'll die, people will devour us.
他们会把我们吃掉，我们会死的。
But CalebOvercome the distraction.
可是加勒他胜过这样的考验。
He believes in God.
他相信神。
He don't really care about what other people say.
他不太在乎别人怎么说。
Even though he tried to change other people.
甚至他还想要改变别人的想法。
Let's read verse chapter 14.
我们来看十四章。
Verse 6.
第六节。
Chapter 14, verse 6.
十四章第六节。窥探地的人中，嫩的儿子约书亚和耶弗尼的儿子加勒撕裂衣服。
Verse 7.
第七，对以色列全会众说：“我们所窥探经过之地是极美之地。
”Verse 8.
第八，耶和华若喜悦我们，就必将我们领进那地，把地赐给我们。那地原是流奶与蜜之地。
Verse 9.
第九，但你们不可背叛耶和华，也不要怕那地的居民，因为他们是我们的食物。并且硬币他们的已经离开他们，有耶和华与我们同在，不要怕他们。
This is why Caleb eventually he can enter the land of Canaan.
这个地方就是加勒他为什么可以进入迦南地的原因。
He has faith in God.
他对神非常有信心。
He's not distracted by the majority view.
他并没有被多数人所影响。
Even 99% of the people say no, don't go.
甚至有99%的人都说不要去。
But he just insists.I have to trust in God. We have to trust in God.
可是他非常的坚持说，我们一定要相信神。
Nowadays, brother and sister, we must understand, if you are a believer of God, you are a Christian, you are the minority in the society.
各位弟兄姐妹，今天我们来跟随主耶稣，我们必须要知道，我们是这个社会上的少数人。
We are so tiny, consider the population of the whole world.
我们跟整个全球的人口来比起来，我们是非常非常少数的。
Especially in Canada nowadays, even though originally it is a Christian-founded country.
虽然在加拿大原本是一个基督教国家。
However, right now, majority of the view, they don't really care about God or the Bible or what God think.
不过在现在的社会上，大多数人他们并不在乎神或是圣经的教导。
They think more about human rights, human freedom,
他们觉得人权与自由是更重要的。
Actually, people have removed religion, removed faith from school, from a society, from a culture.
甚至政府还把宗教信仰从学校、从社会中拿走。
So if you tell other people what we think from the Bible, you'll be mocked at, be prepared, you'll be ridiculed, you'll be sidelined.
所以，请你预备。 你的心。当你在跟你身边的人在解释圣经，在解释神的想法的时候，你会被取笑的。
If you tell them what is right from the God's will, they don't like to hear that.
如果你告诉他们从神的角度来看什么才是对的，他们是不想听见这些话的。
During the SSC, one of the students testified.
在学生联合会里面有一个学生这么做见证。
Actually, the student was not baptized yet.
虽然那个学生是还没有受洗的慕道者，
from a young age, she come to church.
可是从小他就来到教会。
And recently, she even changed for the past year. She changed to a Christian school, private Christian school.
而且从过去的一年，他已经被转入一个私立的基督教学校来就读。
Because she was thinking, compared to public school, maybe the Christian school children are better.
因为他的父母觉得说，跟一般公立小学比起来，应该基督教的私校是比较好的。
Because most of the students should be already Christian, that's why you join a Christian school.
因为他们觉得应该所有的学生都是基督徒，所以他们就觉得这样是比较好的选择。
But the fact is not true. It's not what you expect.
可是结果并不是父母所想的那样。
The student had a lot of friends.
这个孩子在学校有很多朋友。
And when they talk about the issue of LGBTQ,
所以当他们在讨论这个政府所发布的这些信项，
a lot of students, even though they are youngsters, but they already say, "Oh, I'm gay, I'm lesbian, I'm LGBTQ."
他们同学里面虽然年纪都不大，可是他们大家都开始宣称自己是同性恋或是双性恋。
And they say, "I support this."
他们说，我们支持这个。
And they ask her, our little girl, what do you think?
他们问这个小朋友说，你觉得怎么样？
And then the little girl, because she knows the Bible, she from a young age, she read the Bible, she learned what is the word of God.
因为这个小小的慕道者，他从小就已经来到教会。
And then she was very honest. She said that, you know what, this is not right.
所以他就很诚实地告诉他的同学说，这个不对吧？
Because she thinks the rest of you are Christian, that's why you go to Christian school.
因为他想说，你们不都是基督徒吗？所以我可以跟你们分享圣经的看法。
But guess what? All those students, they gang up against her, and then they bully her or stop to befriend.
所以他这些朋友听了他诚实的想法之后，就不愿意再跟他当朋友了，甚至欺负他。
Because they think you are not up to the world, not up to the standard, not up to the time.
因为他们觉得你怎么会这么奇怪的想法，居然没有跟上这个时代的潮流。
This is what we are facing nowadays.
这就是我们现在所面对的社会。
If you truly follow God, you would truly believe the word of God.
如果你真正的跟随神，相信神的话。
And sometimes people look at you, you're very strange.
有时候社会上的人看着你是觉得你很奇怪的。
You are the only one think like this.
你是唯一一个有这样奇怪想法的人。
Look at Caleb and Joshua, they are the minority. They think that, yeah, we have to believe in God, we have to follow God, and we just go and do it.
我们看看这里的约书亚与加勒，他们就是唯二来相信神的人。
However, other people don't follow them.
可是其他人不愿意听从他们。
Look at that. What do they want to do?
那这里他们想要怎么做呢？
Verse 10.
第十节，但全会众说，拿石头打死他们二人。
Wow, you see, the majority, including other spies or other people, they were gang up. Oh, they want to throw stone to Joshua and Caleb and kill them.
这时候全会众说要拿石头打死他们呢。
However, God.Do not permit this to happen.
可是神不愿意这样的事情发生。
So God's glory, let's read on, God's glory.
所以我们继续读下去，忽然耶和华的荣光在会幕中向以色列众人显现。
Wow. Where did God, who did God support, who did God approve? God is very clear here.
这里我们看得很清楚，神是在支持哪一边呢？
God did not rest on the majority.
神并没有站在多数人当中。
God with the one who follow his word.
神是跟着神是对着那个跟着他的人
所显现。So now today, spiritually, we are walking in this journey.
所以今天我们在走属灵的天国路。
You will face a lot of tests, a lot of trial from other people's comments or opinion.
我们每一个人都会经过很多的考验，包含他人对我们的目光。
They will say, "What are you doing?"
他们会说，你到底在做什么？
Why are you different than the rest of the world?
为什么你跟这个世界这么不一样？
Why do you have to be so strange?
你为什么要这么奇怪呢？
Why don't you follow us?
你为什么就不跟我们一样呢？
Yeah, if you follow the flow, if you follow the majority.
是的，如果你跟从今世的潮流。
Just like the social experiment I mentioned it earlier.
就像我刚刚提到的这个心理实验。
People, a lot of people just do something because other people are doing it.
有些人做事就是因为别人也这么做。
Or don't do something because other people are not doing it.
那他们不做某些事也是因为别人都不这么做。
But for us, we are followers of God.
不过对于我们这些跟随主的人，
We follow God. Whatever God wants us to do, even though the rest of the world don't do it, we have to follow on.
不过我们如果是真正跟随神的话，就算别人不这么做，我们还是要继续这么做。
For example, keeping the Sabbath day, worship the true God.
就像遵守安息圣日一样。
Live a holy life.
或者是过一个圣洁的生活。
These are very strange things in the worldly standard.
这个对世界人来说是非常奇怪的事情。
However, if you do this, God will delight on you. God will be with you.
但是如果你这么坚持的话，神就会与你同在。
Look at all these people. They try to stone Joshua and Caleb. Where are they now?
我们看看这些全会众，他们想要拿石头打死这两人，现在他们在哪里？
Eventually, they fall in the wilderness. They never make it to Canaan.
他们最后是倒闭在旷野，没有办法进入迦南地的。
Joshua and Canaan are the only two who went to the Canaan.
但是约书亚与加勒是唯二进入迦南地的人。
So, fully follow God.
所以这里要全心的跟随神。
First test is you must overcome the opinion, comment from other people.
第一个考验就是你必须通过他人的目光。
So, if you really care about what other people think, it's very difficult for you to enter the kingdom of God.
所以如果你想要进入神的国，又同时很惧怕别人的目光的话，这是很困难的。
You can only choose one.
你只能选择一边。
Second test Caleb must overcome.
第二个加勒要通过的考验是
He overcame the test of time.
他通过时间的考验。
Time is a big test.
时间是最大的考验。
Let's see how long did he endure the test of time.
我们看看他到底承担了多久的时间上的考验。
Let's turn to the book of Joshua chapter 14.
我们来看约书亚记第十四章。
Verse 10.
第十节。
Chapter 14, verse 10.
第十四章第十节。自从耶和华对摩西说这话的时候，耶和华照他所应许的，使我存活这四十五年。期间以色列人在旷野行走，看哪，现今我八十五岁了。
Wow, look at how long did...Caleb survived the test of time.
我们看看加勒对于这个时间上的考验到底存活了多久。
40 years ago, he overcame the test of other people.
40年前他通过了他人的目光的这个考验。
But he did not get the blessing immediately.
可是他并没有马上得到他所想要的东西。
God did not just send him, Okay, Caleb, because you're so good, tomorrow morning I'll give you a direct ticket, go to the land of Canaan, you live there and enjoy life.
神并没有跟他说，加勒，你做得很好，所以明天我就直接送你进迦南。
No.
没有。
Tomorrow life is still go on, the same routine.
明日还是过一样的日子。
You have to with the rest of the people going round and round and round and round with the land of wilderness.
你要跟其他的以色列人一样在旷野里面一直绕一直绕。
You have to wait for them to die.
你要等到他们全数死亡。
Sometimes,I think if we are like Caleb, I think we will complain. Why, God, why don't you give me the land, promised land today? I don't have to wait.
如果我们是加勒的话，很有可能我们当场就会向神发怨言。为什么我的心智跟他们不一样，却要跟他们走一样的路呢？
Why can you shorten the time?
为什么你不能把这时间缩短呢？
God give Caleb another test.
所以这时候神给加勒另外一个考验。
The test is time.
这个考验就是时间。
How long is the wait?
到底要等多久呢？
45 years now.
45年了。
How many of you are 45 years old? If you are zero, when you are born until 45 years old, that period is very long.
从零岁活到45岁，这是一段不短的岁月。
You have to wait so long.
你要等这么久。
Today, nowadays, if you go to Tim Hortons, you order a coffee, you wait for 5 minutes already, you say, why so long? Where's my coffee?
今天你走进咖啡厅，你点了一杯咖啡，等了五分钟还没来，你就觉得太久了吧。
You take a, you go to the flight, but you long line up. Nowadays, if you go to airport, line is long. If you wait for 4 hours, you already complain. Why?
今天如果你去机场等飞机的话，让你等了四个小时还没有排好队，你一定会发脾气的。
Or you sit on the plane, you already landed, but you cannot get off the plane because of some delay. You wait, sit there for 4 hours. I think you just shout.
或者是当你降落了，可是还不能下飞机，等了四个小时，你也会受不了。
Because we don't like waiting.
因为我们都不喜欢等待。
Because waiting really tests your patience.
因为等待真的考验一个人的耐心。
Nowadays everything is fast, but our patience is so short.
现在是个速食的时代，可是我们的耐心是这么的少。
So Caleb, God tests him. Now, from the moment I promise you about this land you can enter until you get in, 45 years.
这里神照他的应许的使他存活四十五年。
If Caleb didn't have faith,
如果加勒没有信心的话，
he cannot pass this time of test.
他应该是通过不了这时间的考验。
Let's turn to Romans.
我们来看看罗马书。
Romans chapter 5.
罗马书第五章。
Romans chapter 5 verse 4 to 5.
第五章第四到第五节。
Romans chapter 5 verse 4.
罗马书第五章第四节。忍耐生老练，老练生盼望，盼望不至于羞耻，因为所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们心里。
Here is a perseverance produce character.
这里说到忍耐生老练。
Yeah, sometimes your character is you have some weaknesses in your character.
有时候我们的个性上就是有一些缺点。
When we become parents,
当我们成为父母的时候
，usually we lacking of patience.
通常我们都是没什么耐心的。
But God gives our children to train us patient.
可是神借着孩子来操练我们的耐心。
And suddenly, you know, your children become like a teenager. Oh, really, really give you a hard time.
后来等到你的孩子从儿童变成青少年的时候，你就知道考验来了。
But you cannot lose your temper. You cannot shout with them because they are already teenager.
可是你不可以在这时候失去你的忍耐。
And then you have to develop a better character.
然后你慢慢的从忍耐就会生出老练来。
Okay, I have to be patient. I have to change my character. I have to be slower. I have to be more gentle.
是的，我要变得更有温柔，更有耐心。
And then, all suddenly, you have hope.
这里老练就会生出盼望。
Ah, you wait that one day he'll grow up.
你慢慢的等，有一天他是会长大的。
Oh, then the hope will not disappoint us.
盼望不至于羞耻。
So this is how God trained us.
这就是神训练我们的过程。
This is how God trained Caleb.
这也是神训练加勒的过程。
Even though he has strong faith, but his character is not perfect.
就算他有坚强的信心，可是他的个性是没有到非常完美的。
Yes, God promised him the promised land.
是神应许要给他迦南地。
But it takes 45 years to perfect his character.
可是用这45年来操练他，成为一个老练的人。
This is called a test of time.
这个就是时间上的考验。
Whatever not perfect in our character, God wants to train it.
在我们个性上的缺点，神就是想要训练我们。
Think about brother and sister. The moment you are baptized, your sins wash away.
各位弟兄姐妹，当你受洗的那一天，就是你的罪被洗掉的那一天。
Supposingly, you are quite perfect, right?
应该是从那一天你就完美了吧。
God can take you to heaven directly.
神是可以直接把你从那一天就接回天家的。
Isn't it very nice?
是不是非常好呢？
Yeah, in theory, it's very nice. But practically, if it's like this, I think nobody want to get baptized.
听起来是不错，不过如果一受洗就被接回天家，这样没有人要受洗吧？
Because people don't want to die so quickly.
因为没有人想这么快就死掉。
But at the same time, God wants us to give us a lot of time to test our faith.
所以神就会用接下来的时间来考验我们的信心。
And also to change your character.
同时也来改变我们的个性。
Think about this pandemic. Does it change your character?
我们来看看这个疫情有没有改变我们的个性呢？
The difficulty you have faced in 2021, did it change your character?
在这2021年所面对的挑战，你有没有被它改变了你的个性呢？
You know when God gives you a difficulties,
当神给我们挑战的时候，
whether it's a teenager,
不管是对于青少年，
or you have a sickness,
或者是一个生病的人，
or it's a tough job,
或者是一个很艰难的工作，
or the boss or the colleagues that you don't like,
或者是你不喜欢的老板或者是同事。
God wants to change our character, develop our character.
神想要用他们来改变我们的个性。
Because through time, facing this difficulty, our character become better and better.
因为通过时间上的考验，用这些人来让我们越来越老练。
So thank God in Joshua here, he waited 45 years and he almost get to the land of Canaan.
所以在这里，加勒他通过了这45年的考验，他终于要进去迦南地了。
Now, brother and sister, are you facing the test of time?
弟兄姐妹，你有没有面对时间的考验呢？
Some people, when they are baptized, the beginning, they are very fervent.
有些人在刚受洗的时候，他们非常的热心。
But after a while, they disappear.
可是经过一段日子，他们就不见了。
So usually, it takes 3 years for the first 3 years to test the faith of the newly baptized.
所以通常在受洗的那三年以内是一个非常大的考验。
But afterwards, you still have to face the test.
不过在通过三年之后，我们还是会面对接下来的挑战。
Some people when they were young, they're very fervent.
有些人是在年轻的时候非常的热心。
But after 10-20 years later, it's not the same.
不过在10-20年之后，他们就不再热心了。
Some people when they get old, they left the faith.
有些人甚至在老年就离开了教会。
But look at one person who overcome the test of time.
我们来看看，还有一个人，他是面对 通过了时间的考验。
Let's turn to Luke chapter 2.
我们来看路加福音第二章。
Luke chapter 2.
路加福音第二章。
Verse 36 to 37.
第三十六跟三十七节。
Luke chapter 2, verse 36 to 37.
路加福音第二章三十六跟三十七节。又有女先知名叫亚拿，是亚瑟支派法内利的女儿，年纪已经老迈，从做童女出嫁的时候同丈夫住了七年就寡居了。
37。
三十七节，现在已经84岁，并不离开圣殿，禁食祈求昼夜侍奉神。
Wow, look at this woman called Anna.
我们来看看这个亚拿。
And she was a prophetess.
她是一个女先知。
How long she had been following God?
她到底跟随神多久了呢？
Wow, at least right now she is 84 years old.
她已经84岁。
When she was very young, her husband died.
她在很年轻的时候，她的丈夫就过世了。
So that make her life very tough.
所以她的生活一定不怎么好过。
But she did not complain God.
可是她没有抱怨神。
She trusts in God.
她继续相信神。
She said to herself, I don't have a husband to trust, then I have to trust God.
她说、哦、我没有丈夫可以依靠，那我要依靠神。
So until 84 years old, she is still serving in the temple.
所以当他已经84岁，他还是在圣殿里面。
So this is called a test of time.
这就是时间上的考验。
Brother and sister, can you stand the test of time?
弟兄姐妹，你可以通过时间的考验吗？
Let's look at the, not, don't even talk about the faith, talk about your marriage.
我们不谈信心，我们来谈你的婚姻。
When people first get married, they always say, oh, I love you to the end of the world, nothing can change me, right?
当、人们在要、结婚之前，他们会说我爱你一辈子。
The newlywed always say these kind of things. 新结婚的人。
哦，刚结婚的人才会这么说。
Oh, I love you so much.
我很爱你。
Until the sea went dry.
直到海枯石烂。
Yeah, the stone disappear.
爱你爱到这石头都烂掉。
Oh, is it true?
这是真的吗？
After a few years, they change and love another woman, love another man.
可是过了几年之后，他们就爱上其他人了。
Oh, now because in the past, people used to say it's a 7-year itches.
以前的人说婚姻有七年之痒。
If you get married at 7 years, very dangerous. Usually you feel itching, right?
他们说你结婚七年的时候就会觉得浑身发痒。
This means not allergy, but you look at other people, you like other people, you're attracted by other people.
那并不是指着你身体会过敏，而是你看到其他人就会有兴趣。
But nowadays, it's not even 7 years itches. It's every day you can feel itches.
现在不是七年之痒，现在是每天都痒。
You don't have to wait 7 years.
你不用等到七年。
Nowadays, very few marriage can pass 2 or 3 years.
现在很少的婚姻可以通过两三年。
Because time is a test.
因为时间就是个考验。
At the beginning, what you say doesn't really matter.
在刚开始你所说的那些话一点都不重要。
But how can you maintain throughout the years you still maintain your love, your faithfulness, your devotion to your spouse?
在婚姻里面每一天都在考验着你对另外一半的忠诚还有爱。
When temptation comes, when someone who is very attractive comes,
当一些很吸引人的人靠近的时候。
But do you still remember what do you promise your wife or your husband at the beginning?
你是不是还记得你对另外一半的誓言呢？
Or when times become very bad,
或是当时事非常艰难的时候
，Do you still keep your faithfulness？
你是不是还对另外一半非常忠心呢
？When the marriage, where usually the marriage vow for the good time and the bad time till life or death, right？
在婚礼里面的誓言，就是说我们不管在这个情势好坏，我们都要跟另外一半在一起。
In health or your sickness，
不管你健康还是你生病
，You have to stand by the person。
你就是要很忠实的在他身边。
Yeah, now you marry him or her, she's very beautiful, she's very young。
是的。站在你面前这个人他非常的好看也非常的青春。
The wedding day, everything is so perfect.
在婚礼那一天什么都是非常美好的。
But afterward, things will change.
可是在婚姻里面什么都会改变的。
Time will change. Maybe your appearance will change. Your health will change. Your wealth will change.
时间会改变一个人的外表还有他的魅力还有他的健康。
Can you still stand the test of time?
你是不是还会站在那个人身边呢？
Our relationship with God is the same.
我们与神的关系也是一样。
Can you stand the test of time?
我们能不能通过这时间上的考验？
A few days ago, yesterday, there was during the SSC, one of the student grandparents come to the church.
在学生联会的时候，有一个学生的祖父母来到教会。
I haven't seen him for more than 2 years because of the COVID.
因为疫情的关系，我大概有2年没有见到他们了。
Because he's a very old person, 96 years old.
因为他已经非常的年迈，96岁了。
His wife is 80 years old.
他的太太有80岁。
So they didn't have the vaccine before, so they couldn't feel safe to come to church.
因为他们没有打疫苗，所以他们觉得出门不安心。
So, but they decided they have to go to get a shot.
可是后来他们决定要去打针。
So I see him coming to church.
所以我看到他们走进教会。
And because they think, oh, today, a spiritual convocation, my grandchildren are here.
因为他们觉得他们要来看他们的孙子。
They come to the church to pray.
他们来到教会祷告。
Even for the past 2 years, they couldn't make it to the chapel.
虽然在过去两年他们没有来到会堂。
But at the home, they pray every Sabbath.
不过在家里他们每天都在祷告。
They keep their faith.
他们保持他们的信仰。
And they make it to the church yet a few days ago.
而且他们前几天特地来到教会。
When I see them, my heart is so thankful to God.
当我见到他们，我的心充满了感谢。
Somebody can believe for Lord Jesus Christ more than 50 years.
有些人可以信主、跟随主超过50年。
Even though they are very old, they still maintain the faith.
虽然他们已经非常年迈，可是他们还是保守他们的信仰。
That's why there's a good tradition in our church. We do senior appreciation days, right? Senior appreciation days.
这就是为什么我们真耶稣教会常常举办一个叫敬老会。
Actually, in the old days, we do it every single year.
在以往我们每一年都会举办敬老会。
The church will prepare some gifts, some flowers, and then the old people, the senior, they will be very happy, lining up here to take pictures. They're so happy.
教会会准备一些鲜花或者是礼品给这些老人家，他们会站在前面这里拍照。
And the young children will give them a gift on behalf of the church.
小朋友就会送他们礼物。
I think in the church we should do it regularly, no matter what happens, we should do it.
那我想我们的教会应该也要开始来想一想什么时候要举办敬老会。
Regularly.
是很固定的。
We appreciate the senior.
我们对这些老人家应该要有敬重的。
Why?Because they have kept the faith until the old age.
为什么呢？因为他们可以保守自己的信仰直到年老。
It's not easy.
这并不容易。
They go through the test of time.
他们通过了时间的考验。
So we should appreciate them. We should thank God for them.
所以我们应该为他们来感谢神。
And then give them small gifts, make them happy too.
而且也送他们小小礼物，让他们开心。
And teach the young people how to respect old people. This is our tradition. Good teaching from the Bible.
也同时教导我们如何去敬重这些老人家，这同时也是圣经的教导。
Now, if you are senior, if you are past 65 years old, right, you should be happy to receive this appreciation.
那如果你已经超过65岁的话，你是长者，你就应该也要很开心来参加敬老会。
In the past, some members have a wrong concept.
在过去，有一些人有错误的观念。
Oh, I'm not old, even though I'm 65. Why do you give me a gift?
有些人不承认自己已经老了，他说虽然我已经过了65，可是你不要给我东西。
You put them in the name list, they are not happy. They give you a face.
你把他们的名字放在敬老名单上，他们不高兴。
They tell you, I'm not come on that day.
他说我那天不会来的。
I don't want the people let them know my age.
我不想要别人知道我已经65岁。
Why are you so particular about your age?
为什么你要这么强调你自己的年纪呢？
Why are you so afraid to get old?
为什么你这么害怕老呢？
Getting old is not a problem.
变老不是一个问题。
Everybody will get old.
每个人都会变老的。
The most important thing is you're old, but you're still in the faith.
重点是你虽然老迈，可是还是保守自己的信仰。
You're old, you're going through the pass through the test of time.
你这么年迈还在主里面，就表示你已经通过信仰的考验。
You know, I really wish that I can get the prize. No, 65, I still have 20, not 20, less than 20 years.
我大概在十几年，我就可以被敬老了。
Wow, if you still keep the 65 years old.
如果教会的界限还是在65岁的话
I still have 17 years to wait. Sometimes I cannot, I wish I can get it now. 不用等那么久。
我想我不太想等那么久。
You know, sometimes I go to shop at Drug Mart.
有时候我去药店。
Actually, a few times already.
其实已经好几次。
People ask me.
有些店员告诉我。
Do you need a senior discount?
你需要老年优惠吗？
I said, what?
我说什么？
You need senior discount?
你需要老人家的优惠吗？
I said, what age?
我说是几岁啊？
55.
他说55.
Shopper Drug Mart is even better. 55, you get senior discount.
那个药房他比较年纪的界限比较低，他说55岁就可以了。
At the beginning, I was really sad. Do I look 55 years old?
刚开始我有点失望，我想说我有这
or senior discount. I don't even say anything. They ask me, okay, you want? They assume that I am qualified.
他们觉得我应该是符合这个条件。
But actually, later I thank God. If I look old, I thank God too.
如果我看起来有点老的话，其实我也是蛮感谢神的。
If one day I can get so old and can get a senior appreciation day in the church, That means I keep myself in the faith.
我就想说，如果有一天我可以在敬老会的时候来到前面，那其实也表示我已经坚持住我的信仰。
I did not leave God before I get that age.
我没有在65岁之前离开了神。
And I also can go to Super Drug Mart and get a 10% discount.
我也可以在
buy the milk.
我也可以在药店里面买一些东西，用这个老年优惠。
So now I'm very happy when they ask me.
现在他们问我，我也很开心。
I say, of course, I have to be honest. Say no, not yet.
当然，我是很诚实说没有，我还没到那个年纪。
Maybe next time I just tell them, just give me, don't ask.
下次我可能会就说，你决定这样就这样吧。
So we have to go pass through the test of time.
这里告诉我们要通过时间的考验。
The third test Caleb have to overcome.
第三个加勒要通过时间，要通过的考验是。
Let's turn to Joshua chapter 14.
我们再看回来约书亚记第十四章。
Joshua chapter 14.
第十四章。
Verse 10.
第十节。
Joshua 14 verse 10.
约书亚记第十四章第十节。自从耶和华对摩西说这话的时候，耶和华照他所应许的，使我存活这45年。期间以色列人在旷野行走，看哪，现今我85岁了。
Verse 11.
十一节，我还是强壮，像摩西打发我去的那天一样。无论是征战是出入，我的力量那时如何，现在还是如何。
Verse 12.
十二节，求你将耶和华那日应许我的这山地给我，那里有亚纳族人，并宽大坚固的城，你也曾听见了。或者耶和华照他所应许的与我同在，我就把他们赶出去。
The third enemies, the third challenges facing Caleb is the enemy from outside.
第三个考验就是外在的敌人。
Including the tribe from Anak in verse 12.
在第十二节提到的亚纳族人。
Because this Anak, this Gentile tribe, they're living in the promised land.
因为这个亚纳族人，他们是住在这个迦南地。
So Caleb has to kick them out and then to fight them so that they can receive this promised land.
加勒还想靠着神的应许把他们赶出去。
So today we have to overcome this spiritual enemy.
今天我们同时要面对一样的这个属灵的敌人。
Yes, we have to overcome the test of time.
我们要胜过时间的考验。
Yes, sometimes we have to overcome the test of other people, their comment.
是的，有时候我们要通过其他人对我们的看法这样的考验。
But don't forget, there's one enemy. This is the toughest.
可是不要忘记有一个最大的敌人。
This enemy is a spiritual enemy.
这个最大的敌人是属灵上的。
Who is the spiritual enemy?
谁是我们属灵上的敌人呢？
It's the devil. He didn't want you to go to heaven. He didn't want you to give you the land. He didn't want you to let you to receive the blessing.
就是不想要你得到福气，不想要你进入迦南地的那个魔鬼。
So we have to overcome them.
所以我们要胜过。
Let's turn to Ephesians.
我们来看以弗所书。
Ephesians chapter 6.
以弗所书第六章。
Verse 10 to 12.
第六章第十节到第十二节。第十节，我还有末了的话，你们要靠着主，依赖他的大能大力，做刚强的人。十一节，要穿戴神所赐的全副军装，就能抵挡魔鬼的诡计。
Here said, we will face the enemy, who is the devil.
这里讲到我们要抵挡魔鬼。
Verse 12.
第十二节，因我们并不是与属血气的征战，乃是与那些执政的、掌权的、管辖这幽暗世界的，以及天空属灵气的恶魔征战。
In the past, Caleb have to fight the Anakites.
在古时，加勒要面对亚纳族人。
It's very tough.
是非常困难的。
Now we are facing a spiritual enemy, even tougher.
今天我们所面对更困难的敌人。
Because you don't see this enemy.
因为你看不见他。
It's not belong to the world. It's not physical.
它并不是物质界的。
If it's a physical enemy, you're easy to see them. They come to you, you know how to defend.
如果它是物质界的，我们看得见它，我们就知道要抵挡它。
But it's a spiritual enemy.
可是它是属天空、属灵气。
They are stronger than us.
他们比我们坚强。
The devil want to use our evil desire to attack us.
他们想要用我们心里面的恶欲来攻击我们。
So that we'll become proud or we'll go against God's will.
让我们心里会起骄傲来抵挡神。
Or sin against God.
或者是犯罪得罪神
or have the heart of disbelief,
或者是生出不信的心
or have pride,
或者心里有骄傲
No, devil is so cunning, he can use every way to attack us.
魔鬼非常的狡猾，他可以用各种各样的方式来对付我们
And the problem is he's stronger than us.
而且重点是他比我们强壮许多
Because he's spiritual.
因为他是属灵的
Just like the Anakites, they are stronger than the Israelites.
就像亚纳族人是比以色列人更强壮的。
If you rely on yourself, you cannot overcome them.
如果你靠着自己，你是没有办法打赢他的。
But thank God, Paul said, there's only one way you can overcome them.
可是感谢神，这里保罗告诉我们有一个方法，我们可以打赢。
You have to put on the full armor of God.
你要穿戴神所赐的全副军装。
Just like the Roman soldier, they have full armor. They can well protect themselves and win a battle.
就像罗马士兵，他们可以有全副的军装来保护自己。
That's why Roman soldiers are very strong in those times.
所以罗马兵他们在以前的世界是所向无敌的。
Now spiritually, we have all this weapon and spiritual armor of God.
在属灵上，我们也是要穿戴神所赐的全副军装。
In the future, we can study the full armor of God, what they are.
以后我们可以好好的来跟大家一起学习这全副军装是什么。
But the last one is the most important one.
最后是一个最重要的。
Verse 17, let's read verse 17.
第十七节，第十七节，并戴上救恩的头盔，拿着圣灵的宝剑，就是神的道。
Wow, the concluding, the most important weapon of the full armor of God is the word of God.
在这全副军装里面，最重要的就是最后的这个神的道。
Plus the helmet.
还有救恩的头盔。
Helmet is to keep your head.
头盔是保护我们的头。
If you protect other part of the body, but you don't keep your head, you get healed, you get killed, and then you get defeated.
如果我们穿戴了军装，可是忘了保护自己的头，我们就很容易被打击。
So most importantly is to keep your head.
所以最重要的就是保护自己的头。
Keep your thinking.
保护你的思想。
Keep your mind.
保护你的观念。
What can be done to keep your head?
怎么样可以保护自己的头呢？
Salvation, the helmet of salvation.
就是救恩的头盔。
Just like the past 6 days, all the children learn about salvation.
就是在过去的六天，学生联欢会，他们都学习了救恩。
They pray.
他们祷告。
So they're just like receiving the helmet.
所以这些孩子就像得到了救恩的头盔。
Protect their heart, protect their mind from the worldly fiery arrow.
保护了自己的思想还有观念从这个世界上逃走。
And then the young children, students, spiritual convocation, they are taught the word of God.
在学生联会的时候他们与神对话。
They were taught the word of God.
他们学习神的道。
They're just like giving the sword that can attack, it can defend and also attack.
他们就像拿着圣灵的宝剑可以抵挡魔鬼。
When temptation comes, they know how to fight.
当诱惑来到的时候，他们知道要怎么样去打这场仗。
So this is how Caleb won the enemy.
这个就是加勒他如何胜过他的敌人。
So Caleb overcome, fully follow God, overcome 3 enemies.
所以加勒他专心的跟随神，而且胜过三个考验。
First, overcome other people's opinion.
第一个是别人对他的看法。
Don't care what other people say.
他不管别人怎么说。
He follow God with trust.
他就是专一跟随神。
Secondly, overcome the test of time.
第二，他胜过时间的考验。
45 years, never changed his mind.
45年了，他从未改变过他的心。
In Chinese, it's called 初心啊，不忘初心。Don't forget what your original intention at the beginning.
在中文里面说不忘初心。
Thirdly, he overcome the spiritual enemy.
第三个就是他赢过了属灵的敌人。
May God help us.
求神帮助我们。
Let's sing hymn 498.
我们一起来唱诗498首。